What's the deal with Japanese Fenders? Hello, it is a lovely sunny day here in Guitar Epsom, and we thought it would be a good opportunity to talk about Japanese Fenders. Fenders that are made in Japan. Why do they exist? What are they? Are they any good? Should you get one? So let's just get straight into it and let's talk about the why. So if you want to have a more detailed explanation of Fender Japan and their origins, then I highly recommend reading our blog on guitarguitar.co.uk, which has got a really comprehensive retelling of the Fender Japan story. And it's a really interesting one and one really worth knowing about. So I'll just kind of summarize it. If you are somewhat familiar with Fender, then you'll know that Fenders are usually made in America. And in the 70s and 80s, Fender was owned by a company called CBS. And that was an era that quite a lot of people are critical of with Fender. I'm personally more of a fan of it than some people are. I like quite a lot of the designs from that era. But I do also understand that quality around that time, for some people, wasn't where it was expected to be with Fender. And a lot of markets kind of responded to that. And one market that dealt with the supposed decline in quality in a big way was the Japanese guitar market. And there were a lot of companies who were making copies of Fenders, and not copies like you would see today where maybe, you know, they've changed a slight thing about the design. I'm talking like same headstock, same body shape, same everything, trying to get the pickups as close as possible. And basically just Fender copies without Fender on the headstock. And people loved those guitars. A lot of those are what we would call lawsuit era guitars. And Fender caught wind of this, and they obviously saw a gap in the market that they could take control of. Fender then ended up working with a few of those companies to license them to make Fender guitars in Japan. And it worked. These guitars are hugely popular. People absolutely love them. If you are lucky enough to play a 80s, 90s, Japanese Fender, then you know how good they are. And for a lot of people, they rival a lot of the American guitars being built back then, if not basically blow them out of the water, which is crazy. And Fender have never stopped making guitars in Japan. It is a huge guitar market, and actually a market that a lot of the time doesn't even really cross over outside of that part of the world. Since then, Fender's production in Japan has changed hands, and it is now basically completely controlled by Fender. In the last decade, Fender actually have their own division in Japan making these guitars. So you know it's kind of got that authenticity that you would expect from a Fender. And that's the briefest history I can tell on Fender Japan. So now moving on to the why does Fender Japan still exist? It is a different market to what it was 30, 40 years ago. Why would a Japanese Fender be a good purchase? Thank you. So I haven't really spoken about this guitar in my hand too much, but I will now. So this is a Made in Japan Traditional 2 Fender, and it's a 60s Strat, basically. It's a 60s spec Stratocaster. Now, if you're familiar with the Fender range, you'll be aware of the fact that Fender basically has two main factories, one in Mexico, one in America. So if you wanted a vintage spec American Fender, then you would buy something from the American Vintage 2 range. If you wanted something slightly more affordable, made in Mexico, then you would go for the Vintera range. And that's about it. With this, there's something in between in terms of quality and budget. And that's massive, because when you're considering that, you know, there could be a price difference of nearly £1,000 between those two ranges. To have something that sits a little bit more comfortably in the middle, that gives you all of the quality that you would expect from a high quality Fender, but is also a little bit kinder to your wallet, it makes total sense. And you've probably already heard some sound bites in this video. You've heard what these sound like. They are great sounding guitars. The pickups in them are amazing. The feel of them is amazing. They're really true to spec. That's not always the case with Japanese Fenders. Fender Japan are actually quite famous for making some unusual spec'd Fenders sometimes, which is kind of part of the fun. It's like you've got your core line stuff that you can get anywhere, but then sometimes Fender Japan might come out with a crazy spec'd up, like you might have like a Jazzmaster with wide range humbuckers or something that came out a few years ago, and that was really fun. And you know, they'll do different takes on those classic Fender ideas, and that's what's really cool about them. But then they do also make these core line Fenders, and you've got to consider that the Japanese guitar market is a huge market. It's an extremely popular market, and a lot of the time Japanese Fenders don't really make it out of there. But sometimes we are very lucky to get some imported to places like Guitar in the UK. It's just super refreshing to play these. They are reasonably priced for, you know, the quality level that they are at. And they're just a lot of fun. I mean, you know, again, I've already mentioned this, but you always hear stories about Japanese Fenders and the quality, and you know, they really live up to that hype. They just are amazing. So to answer that last question that I asked at the beginning of this video, should you own a Japanese Fender? Well, obviously my answer is gonna be yes. But maybe ask yourself a few questions. Are you looking for, you know, a higher quality Fender, something that, you know, you can rely on in terms of, let's say you're touring, or you know you're gonna be recording regularly, or you're gonna be using it day in, day out. You know, maybe you want to just pay just a little bit more to get more guitar, but maybe the American ranges are slightly out of your budget range, which is totally understandable. These really fill a gap that I feel for a little while now hasn't really been filled, and they don't always come around. So when they do, it's a really exciting thing, because as I've already said, you know, Japanese Fenders have got a really, really good reputation for being amazing guitars. And you know, we absolutely love them. And let us know what you think. There's a few sound bites in this video. How do you think they sound? What do you think they compare to? Would you own one? Let us know. Thank you so much for watching. As always, make sure to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions about Japanese Fenders or anything else for that matter, please do not hesitate to ask in the comments below. I've been Vinny from Guitar. We'll see you soon. Bye.